Hello and welcome. We have exhaustively dealt with job description in one of our episodes. I'm very clear that job description has become so much important to all of us. If not, then go through that video because I strongly recommend it for every job aspirant, for every candidate, for every student. Why? You will eventually come out with a solution. And once if you have gone through it, you'll be a confident lot. Very sure. So let's take this to a very specific post called as data analyst. We have seen data analyst as a lot of opportunity being found in the newer arena, you know, in the modern time. And if you look at the past decade as well, data analyst, maybe past two decades for that matter, data analyst was always there and it is going to be there. So data analyst is what? What does the position actually calls for? What it entails, what are the profile, what is that which asks as a description, everything we need to know about data analyst and understand the job description of it. So if you are all game, let's begin understanding as to what is data analyst. Well, we all know that as soon as you complete your bachelor's degree, that is needed for as a basic to start. But if you have master's degree, that will be needed for many upper level jobs. So one thing is for sure, when you have done your bachelor, you should also eye your master's degree. Maybe if that is possible for you to do it parallelly with the job, right? So most analysts will have degrees in fields like maths, statistics, computer science, or something closely related to their field. IT maybe. So strong math and analysis skills are needed. That is primary of data analyst. Now before you apply for any job as a fresher, make sure you have got the following points covered. And what are they? I'll lay them one by one so that you are able to understand every bit of it. One, the first one is analytical skills. Now, data analysts work with large amounts of data, facts, figures, and number crunching. You will need to see the data and analyze it to find conclusion. So, to draw conclusion from data given is the basic understanding under analytical skills. Number two, as any job would entail, this job also requires communication skills. So data analysts are often called to present their findings, and that's the reason they need to effectively communicate it across. If not communication direct, they need to translate sometimes the data into an understandable document. So if it's a document, then still you require the writing communication, the written form of communication. You will need to write and speak clearly. Easily communicating complex idea is the underlying statement of communication skills. To simplify the complex data as a study and maybe put it across, maybe while writing, in a written form or in a spoken form. That's the reason, communication skills. Number three, critical thinking. Data analysts must look at the numbers, trends, and data and come to new conclusions based on the findings, right? So they need to essentially form a logic from the criticality of all the data being filtered and assimilated to form inferences. That is where the critical thinking comes into play. Number four, attention to detail. This I also call as process focus. If you are process focused, results are bound to come, and they are bound to come as desired, as the way it is desired. So data is precise. We know that facts are facts, figures are ultimate, and they are unique. They cannot be altered or tampered anytime. So data analysts have to make sure they are vigilant in their analysis to come to correct conclusion. So what forms is not the conclusion or filtering of data or assimilation of data. I think data mining also has a lot to do with what kind of data is actually good for one process. Maybe first, the second process, or maybe for third process. If there are many processes involved, you need to identify and segregate these under putting yourself attention to detail and maybe segregating these data to conclude it variedly different from the same data, right? And what is math skill? The next one. Data analysts need math, numeric, numerology skills to estimate numerical data. As simple as that. As long as you are going to deal with data, you know, numbers, figures, and most important, the numerology or numeric involved into it, you need to be process driven. And hence, to a larger extent, the math skills comes into play. These are the most important skills that you need to take care of before you proceed to take a job as a fresher. So I am stating this in the light of new graduates, fresh graduates, the first timers, they are applying for data analyst job. What they need to know essentially is very, very clear as of now. Now, data analysts rely on various tools to collect and make sense of their data, isn't it? These are some common tools in a data analyst tool belt. What are they? One is Excel. Now, I would say MS Office Excel is one thing. There's G Suite, which is the Gmail's Excel sheet. So it's called as Google Sheet. Google Sheet is what is the next term for Excel. So you need to be equally competent with both the part. SQL, right? Google Analytics, Visual Website Optimizer, Google Tag Manager, Tableau, Google AdWords. These are all very, very important for data analysts. Now, companies look forward to individuals who are good at programming and databases as they are an important part of the role. There are many companies that hire freshers provided you possess the right set of skills and knowledge about data analysis. Now, there are a lot of companies that hire individuals without prior experience as well. So this is something which every fresher should take a serious note on and start working towards it. You should look at the job description, very important, very carefully, and the prerequisites before you apply anywhere. Always keep your resume, CV, professional profile, or a bio data up to date. Whatever that you have done, your last, which will help you to maybe increase the possibility of your inclusion with any good company, I think you should incorporate in your resume and keep it updated. Now, mention all your relevant skills, all the work you have done, any internships that you have done, projects that you have worked on, etc., etc. And in case if you have a voluntary services or participation, which includes your domain knowledge or technical experience, might as well put that under one of the sequence. Now, these points will help you in getting the role for sure. Now, resources for data analysis courses. Now, Digital Vidya offers a certified data analysis course, which is completely online. So you can have and take a look at this as well, one of the options. Now, on online data analysis courses, Harvard University, this is the second one that I'm laying for you. Number third, data analyst nano degree, Udacity also offers a very good course. Learn data analysis with online courses, edX offers another course on the same line. Now, and always keep learning and gaining knowledge. All companies look for individuals who are proficient and confident in what they have learned. So I'm sure with this very clearly laid down for all of you, if you are aspiring to be data analyst, this should serve as a very important tool to prepare yourself. And if you are aspiring and you do not have any kind of a certification as of yet, you might as well take an help of all those courses that I just mentioned. So I'm very sure data analyst pays you good. Data analyst is going to be here for a futuristic, which is going to stay for a long, long time. So I'm very sure people who have love for maths, who have love for data, who have love for interpretation, who have love to bring it to the right conclusion. I think those are the people which best fits into data analyst. And mind you, it's a great job, provided if you have liking to work in the computer for hours together and you know how to de-stress yourself. So the next time when you're thinking of becoming a data analyst, this video should serve a great purpose, isn't it? So what are you waiting for? Just be best prepared, and thank you.